We were
messing with you earlier. We were going to call you and tell you that the meeting had started 30 minutes early.
The pre-meeting meeting? I've caught a few of those in the past, indeed.
Good to see you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Cool, I only see you.
Where do you do most of your work out of? Cobb or Fulton?
Probably more so in Fulton.
What about Jim?
Fulton.
Neither of y'all doing any groundwork, do you? You can get a bird down there. You told me there's a felony going on. Throw a handful of rocks in any direction and you're going to hit somebody committing a felony down there. Mm-hmm. So, it's too much.
No, that's right.
There's too much crime.
Yeah.
July 6, 2017. I call this meeting to order at 9:02 a.m. Those in attendance are panelist Ms. Heather Stevenson, Mr. Michael O'Hagan, and Mr. Charles Polak. Clerk Shannon Westbrook, Personnel Services Director Pat Carson acting as Assistant Clerk, Complainant Mr. Guidry, Respondent Commissioner Sydney Mills, and the public. The first item on the agenda is the adoption of the agenda. Do I have a motion to adopt?
I move that we adopt the agenda.
Second. All in favor?
Aye. Okay.
The second item on the agenda is to ratify the June 21st, 2017 evidentiary hearing minutes. Do I have a motion?
Motion.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
The third item on the agenda is to ratify the prior action in the prior evidentiary hearing regarding the panel's decision on Mills' motion for directed verdict due to lack of evidence during the 21st evidentiary hearing. Do I have a motion?
So motion.
All in favor?
We
are here today for the panel to reconvene and deliberate and to issue their findings of fact and conclusion of laws in the complaint filed by Mr. Rene Guidry against Commissioner Cindy Mills. Since Mr. Charles Polak had been elected chairman of the investigatory review, he will remain the chairman for today's evidentiary hearing. I will now turn the meeting over to Chairman Polak.
Thank you. Madam Clerk, just to mention one thing that came up before the meeting was the spelling of Mr. Guidry's name. If you can just fix that wherever it appears. Thank you. Well, We have considered the complaint. We have determined that an evidentiary hearing was necessary. We've had the evidentiary hearing, and now it is time for our panel to deliberate and to issue findings of fact and conclusions of law. Has everyone had a chance to digest the information presented thus far?
Yes.
Okay, excellent. I will give my take on where I think we are. Please chime in and let's discuss it. There was a, in response to the complaint, Commissioner Mills' attorney raised the issue of jurisdiction, but I think we've all read the ethics ordinance and determined that it incorporates by reference applicable Georgia law, and I believe the Open Records Act and the county's retention policy both fall within that provision of the ethics ordinance. So I do think that we do have jurisdiction, at least in terms of an ethical issue, to consider the complaint.
Agreed.
The evidence that we saw and heard, and in saying saw, I am not counting the items that arose after the complaint was filed, which would be the open records request from, I don't recall the date, but it was from sometime in June.
Shortly before the hearing.
Yeah, the week before the hearing, I believe. Not considering that. And I'm also not considering the affidavit of Mr. Lipscomb, who wasn't here for a cross-examination. In fact, I didn't even read his affidavit, so I don't know what it says. But considering what's in the complaint and what we heard at the hearing, I don't know that there's any specific communication that would have violated the retention policy. However, we've heard testimony from Commissioner Mills, and we saw written materials regarding her, at least her personal policy of deleting messages. In one case, it said she automatically deletes them, and then in another case, when she testified, she actually said that she manually deletes the messages when there's a space issue on her phone. I think that personal policy probably violates the Open Records Act and violates the county's policy on retention, simply because it's a blanket policy and it makes no distinction whether it's a substantive communication or a non-substantive communication. It's totally indiscriminate as to what she's going to delete. So although I don't think I've seen any evidence of specific substantive communications about whether it's zoning matters or anything else that would be subject to the retention policy, I do think her policy, her personal policy of indiscriminately deleting messages creates a very dangerous situation and has the strong potential of, whether intentionally or inadvertently, violating her retention, document retention requirements and the Open Records Act. For that reason, I would suggest, in terms of a disciplinary action, that we have sort of a spectrum of disciplinary actions, which for county officials, it starts out written warning, censure or reprimand. The next one is removal from office to the extent provided by state law, and then the third one is repayment to the county of any unjust enrichment. I don't think there's any unjust enrichment in this case whatsoever, but I do think that this certainly warrants some sort of a written warning that she needs to preserve communications which are subject to the retention policy. Any thoughts?
I'm sorry, I lost my thought on this.
While you're looking for that, I would just like to say that I agree with Mr. Pollock. I don't think that you were intentionally trying to, I would hope that you weren't intentionally trying to remove any sort of information that was necessary for open records. I understand the text could be very cumbersome. I have years worth of text still. And I don't think that anything as extreme as removal from office is warranted. I just think that you just need to be more careful. We've had their moment here.
Well, I guess the only thing I disagree with is I'm not sure that I agree that we haven't seen anything that says that maybe there's a substitute. Yeah. I don't disagree with the ultimate that I believe that the policy that, I mean, I think that some of these communications that were attached to the complaint could be of substantive value. So, again, I don't necessarily think that I've seen, I can agree that a blanket policy of deleting all messages without regard to content violates the Retention Act. I also think that my understanding of Ms. Bull's testimony was that she could not say for sure that she had never deleted anything of substantive value. So I think all of that combined to me, given the choices that we have, I would agree that probably a written reprimand would be the appropriate recommendation.
And I agree with the, I don't think there's any history of any prior issues with this, so I think a written would be appropriate.
Should someone make a motion?
I'm making a motion that the panel finds that there was a violation of the Forsyth County Ethics Ordinance and that this mutual petition would be issued to the Retention Policy.
I would second.
I would agree with that. So I think we unanimously adopted that motion.
Issuing a written finding, I assume we can just circulate a draft to them and that can be issued.
So,
yes.
So, you will prepare minutes?
Yes, I will prepare minutes.
And we'll use the minutes, because I don't think any of us have really taken much minutes today.
That's fine. I'll prepare them.
We'll use those minutes to prepare the findings of fact and conclusions of law.
Okay.
Any other business?
No.
The business need to address?
Well, actually, one thing I think probably do need to note for the record, there were objections made during the hearing, and I think that we probably need to either note that we're ruling on them not ruling on our decision didn't matter.
Sure, and I think you kind of touched on it, but yeah, just to be clear, the affidavit, I know I didn't look at it.
Right.
Chuck, you said you didn't look at it, or Mr. Pollock, I'm sorry.
That's quite all right. I would move that in terms of the objections as to the affidavit of Mr. Lipscomb, because none of us have looked at it, we consider that to be moot, and no ruling on the objections needed.
And then with the supplemental,
and then the additional, the open records request, which was done shortly before the hearing. Again, none of us looked at it. Again, I think that
I looked at it during the hearing. I will say that.
Okay.
So,
well, to the extent we may have looked at it, it was not a factor in our determination,
sure.
And it also was moved. Second.
Second.
Again, I believe that's also unanimous.
On adoption of today's meeting minutes, I will be issued to the panelists. Do I have a motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Meeting adjourned at 9:14 a.m.
Thank you.
You guys were the first class case to ever reach this hearing with an ethics panel in Forsyth County since the jury read. And yeah, curious if you guys during the process make any kind of exit type of guidelines. You might have recommendations to the county to update the ethics ordinance so that the next group of outside the county attorneys might have a better shot at doing what they're doing. So, but wondering if you had that opportunity. And again, you guys are the first ones to ever reach this point since it was rewritten, I think, in 2010. So just updating you.
Thank you for coming. I want to say, I don't know how you guys lawyer. This was the most difficult thing I've ever done in my life. On hands down. All right. Who's up first?
I'm going to go first. Letter, whatever.
Wow. Easy. I mean, it was quick, yes.
It was a lot.
Right.
No, I penciled their students. Yeah.
We weren't sure. We wanted to provide enough information.
Exactly. Okay.
Wow.
Okay. Thank you all for your time.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
We'll definitely, you know, send you these minutes for adoption and get all that wrapped up.
Okay.
Thank you all for taking the time to come up here this morning.
Sure.
Sure, thank you.
Actually, I wish it would have taken longer because I saw the traffic heading.
That's true.
Okay, good to know. Yes, and he made me aware of that, so I told him I would definitely make the correction.
Okay, cool.